Consequently, the research of textile clothing is brought onto the archaeological sector to help explore the human living conditions and also indirectly community relations, import existence, and so on. Therefore, I chose one specific area on Grobin.
Left.
This. Here. The shop was the object of local and colonies watching information in one costume. But during the second half of the Vandal period, Scandinavian settlers settled in colonial lands, modern day Corsica. According to the currently still uncontested theory, they were Swedes from like mainland area and Gotlandic colonists. Scandinavians buried their dead in a number of nearby cemeteries, in the fourth burial field of Rotterdam and also the burial field in Previous. Evidence of coexistence of settlers and locals is fully visible in archaeological material. Previous one and Rotterdam cemeteries were filled with Scandinavian grave goods, including fragments of military equipment, including helmets, sword parts, spearheads, shield bosses, and so on, jewelry, wood brooches, animal head brooches, and so on, condoms and keys are found. At the same time, in the nearby cemeteries, Previous and Archaeology shows typically chronic grave goods. Also, some potentially Coronian burials also are discovered in Grobin's two burial places, otherwise Scandinavian burial. I will focus my paper in more detail on one of the burials in Rotterdam, burial field. Unfortunately, during this period in Grobin and elsewhere in Gotland and mainland Sweden, women are cremated. In Grobin, usually off the burial site, which does not help to create a full picture of jewelry and its placement in grave. Although this kind of burial rite is not very helpful in keeping textiles. The second question is Grobin. What to call burial number 3? It belonged to a wealthy mid-late or late Iron Age, it depends on the pronunciation of woman. It's in Latvia, it's middle Iron Age, in Scandinavia, it would be late Iron Age. From the early 20th century, the grave was excavated unprofessionally. It is cremation burial, excavated approximately 0.75 cm deep. It was slowly all on top, with a length of 0.5 meters and width 0.4 meters. A lot of grave goods, besides one of bones and calls have been found. Two early animal head brooches with a set of bronze chains with chain holders. Box brooch, bronze decorative pin, several bronze brackets, 89 arm rings, 89 arm rings, hard to establish a correct amount because some of them are broken. Bronze fittings for sewing on the dress, in my opinion, it's big holders. See one here. Some fragments, bronze keys, bronze neck rings, neck ring, bronze pincers, knife, and a lot of bronze and several bronze beads. The concrete complex is interesting in more than only jurisdictions, but also as an element of local influence and also possible bright replicates from the Indian jewelry by locals. Also, the present dating of the grave has not been determined. It fluctuates from 7th up to 9th century. Therefore, closer analysis of the jewelry complex and also comparison with similarities from Scandinavia is needed. If beads are of LCC type, which is more of general Scandinavian origin, then animal head brooches are more GC type, which have more parallels in southern Scandinavia. Box brooch armrings, bead dividers often be dated to 8th century, while decorative pin shows later indications. The parallels for the chain armament is called in Gotland can be dated already to the migration period. Coronian influence can be tracked in several aspects. First is an acronym. documented in Scandinavia approximately 7 from the Late Iron Age, but very widespread in Romanian and Baltic territories as such. Second, the amount of armies. In Gotland and Nerman, the pairing of armies doesn't exceed 2 pairs. At the same time, in Coronian territories, there are more than 2 pairs of armies in the widespread tradition in Gothic graves. Third aspect is a very rare find of King and Ruby helmet, only 2 have been found. And the pathology which does not correspond to the types of things used in Gotland and Denmark at the same time. It was here, this one. And that's the clothing itself. What do we have? What do we have? This one is a burial itself.
What does that look like?
Nothing much. The answer to what we know was a closing. The Northern Europe during the Late Iron Age can be something too low.
Damn little.
The only way to know was at least one woman or man was born upon they would be found at their site of closing. The only way to know was at least one woman. And even then, may but not only for the average people dressed because there is no such thing. The Late Iron Age spent more than 300 years in that geographical area. This is not but assumed like in the later periods, closing varied according to the time, geography, tradition, and personal taste. Even just a small place including one lady who tried to outdo another with a hair just so they were not similar. This means the details of the various were used, including which materials they were made of. Patterns of the weaves and layering of thinner garments and outer garments. We do not know how most of the garments look like the cotton sheet. Interpretations are made by different researchers based on the archaeological finds, periodic descriptions of clothing in later sagas, but this is still best guess based on scant evidence we have. This is Viking period, with all research compared to the dress from earlier period. Let me mention Anders Gay, Elisabeth and Jorgensen, also Ayazarinian, Jerome Ortega. Besides that problem, another is the fact that the planting desk has very few reconstructions, even for Viking Age, the one here. And the same problem also goes for the neighbor of the Roman groups. In addition, the clothing found in graves does not necessarily tell us what people wore in their daily life. Existing information bands provide us a large assortment of distinctive accessories, yet information about Norse clothing does not disperse. With the exception of the few intact garments, only fragments of the clothing have survived due to better soil conditions for organic preservation of burial practices. Reconstruction interpretations are based on multiple sources, such as archaeological finds, accessory styles, Norse stone carvings, gold covers, yellow plates, and leather tapestries, as well as a parallels in other parts of Europe, specifically in case of Grobin, Eastern Baltic. The most direct evidence comes from imprints existing pieces of textiles and jewelry. From the fact that few finds in textile imprints, some could be part of the burial rites and reason for calling a deceased person or as a bedding. Therefore, greater attention should be drawn to the parts of textile which left imprints on jewelry or bones. It should be taken into account that there are small finds of textile imprints in Ruby. And also two pieces of textiles have been found attached to the jewelry. I also looked into the building material searching for evidence, taking into account the fact that written for Scandinavians regulated from this island. Another aspect which should not be ignored is the intercultural connections between locals and Scandinavians, which should be taken into account as well. According to the evidence from Gotland and Latvia, many linen and woolen double fabrics were used. It's possible that also came from Latin America. Two types of fabrics strongly dominate, Bilsu, Tzu, and Teddy. In Gotland, Tzu Tvili reaches up to 77% of textile funds. The same fabric is also widespread in Latvia. We don't have a preserved data, unfortunately. Different from Scandinavia and Latvia, more evidence can be found of the use of linen fabric. Taking into account the mutual relations and mutual impact between Scandinavian colonies and local colonies could be assumed that linen was used more widely than in Gotland. What are the possibilities to get nearest reconstruction of the female costume, the location of brooches, pebbles, and other jewelry? When talking about Scandinavian females, gentlemen's first thought is waiting lady, deserters, brooches, and beads all over Chester. But there are two such figures, and both letters in the 8th century in Grobin, Strathclan, you can see one here. More popular in Grobin is early version of animal head brooch, found in furs. Which gives clue of the purple style garment. Such brooches have been found in more than one grave and mostly dated to 650 up to 750 AD. In one case, it was called grave number 8, that trend followed the 90s. Another group of here is a jewelry which does not have any fastening house. Here are brackets, beads, and other big holders. Chains have also been not being used between animal kit brooches, but also separately, quite possibly for attaching knives, ease, and such things to brooches, for some instances also the brooch belt. The tuning is a part of costumes and starting put together evidence of female deaths. It should be noted that there is no evidence of female shift from Grobin or Gotland. But in continental Sweden, later period Denmark, and also Eastern Baltic, evidence put cost over is the use of linen sheet in also, in some cases, also woolen. Some sparse linen pieces we also have from colonials. A possible shift could also be seen on the landed picture stones. According to the evidence from art and the amount of cost in these people's skins and so on, more than one layer of this were used. Skins of both animal and brooches in this problem is grave number 3, and those brooches as well as decorative pin are thick enough to allow us assume that they were intended to the fastening outer garments. Sheep is made from linen, fabric used in reconstruction, linen tabin, and of the type and of the long sleeves. According to Latin evidence, other sheep, a woolen couple dress is worn, fastened with a pair of animal head brooches. Such kind of dress is known on Scandinavian and also Eastern Baltics. In Scandinavia, as we mentioned, the earlier Denmark finds. A woolen wheel is used for reconstruction. Between brooches, bead holders are put. There are no evidence of bell buckles in female graves, which allows to accept the possibility of the use of textile belts. For cremating, see, such belts would be destroyed entirely. There are also later evidence from Gotland, because of woolen belts are used. Recreation of Colonian belts of the same period as another burial belt. From the belt hands, keys, pincers, and comb. As there are none and direct evidence on footwork, woolen meanings and leather shoes are used. Here you can see also the upper part of the peplum dress with the hoops for fastening to the brooches. And this is the construction of brooches and the chain ornament. As other were either two shells or a woolen kaftan is used. What else is there? Scandinavian possible evidence now. Captain is made from two sorts of wool, filled with a linen lining in the bin and for double woolen borders. In images, captain is held in place by box brooch, while shell is held by pin. You can see this both version on our other layers of the dress. It should be noted that this costume of reconstruction is based on some works of hypothesis, archaeological evidence as well as parallels. It is not possible to create an ethnographic and simply scientifically based reconstruction. However, such speculations and drawing contributes to the more accurate reconstruction of the complex in the future. In conclusion, I would like to say that it's very likely that Gotlandians living in Grobin have taken influence also from the local Colonian Devonians. At the same time, it's regrettable that a complete summary of the excavation in Grobin is not available, and in the existing books by Norman Littleton, textiles are not addressed at all. In theory, there is a possibility that imprints on jewelry for small, partially carbonaceous textile pieces have been preserved. However, it would work in it is a work for the future and could be based on fundamental research we carried out together with the material research in Gotland. Thank you for attention.
Thank you.